A very good day to you all. So this is a continuation of Basics of Software Testing 1 video, and this will cover the topics that includes identifying test cases and an example that can be used in order to derive test cases. So in the first video we covered various levels of abstractions of testing, then testing life cycle, test cases, and the contents a test case should have. So in this we'll see the various ways in which we can identify test cases. So a test case can be identified in two ways. One is using the behavior of the system, and the other one is based on the internal structure of the system. So functional testing is based on the view that a program may be considered to be a function. It is a function, so it maps values from its input domain to the value in its output range. Okay, so it is also called black box approach, whereas structural testing is identifying the test case based on how each function is actually implemented. So each function, how it is implemented, that is all the program constructs. So we are considering software here. So all the program constructs, that is all the function, how it is implemented, all the structure of the code, and what all functions are used, what all function will be called from which part of the code, everything will be considered when we are going for structural testing. So it is also called clear box approach. Clear box approach. So these are the two approaches in deriving test cases. So functional approach, what we do is we will go to the requirements, we will take each requirement, we will map it to the output domain, and we will write a corresponding test case for that. Whereas structural testing, we will see exactly how each function is implemented. So the implementation changes, everything will be considered in structural testing. So now if we see the whole program, the requirements, the program, then the test cases, everything, then we can view it as a Venn diagram. Okay, we can view it as a Venn diagram. So this is the whole program behavior, that is the universe of program behavior, that is all the program behaviors that can exist. Now this is actually the specification or the requirements which is expected by the customer, and this is actually the programmed behavior, or this is actually what is being implemented based on requirements. So this portion, if you see, this is the intersection between the specification and the program, and that means this much is the portion that is specified by the customer and program. So this is the correct region, or this is the expected region. Now if we see, this is actually a modified the Venn diagram, and here we have one more circle, that is test cases. So this new circle is for test cases. Okay, now if we see, we can see each regions here. So if we see the regions 2 and 5, then there may be specified behaviors that are not tested. Specified behaviors that are not tested, that is 2 and 5. Then specified behaviors that are tested, that will come under region 1 and 4. Then test cases that are correspond to unspecified behaviors. So which all regions it will be? That is 3 and 4. Then we have certain regions, that is There may be programmed behaviors that are not tested. So those are 2 and 6. Then programmed behaviors that are tested. That is region 1 and 3. And then there are test cases that corresponds to unprogrammed behaviors. That is 4 and 7. So each of this region is important. Why? If specified behaviors exist for which no test cases are available, the testing is necessarily incomplete. So all this we can identify using this Venn diagram. So this is what, and so based on this we can identify which all the specifications are tested, everything. Now coming to the next part, see, this is an ATM system, SATM system. This system can be used in deriving test cases. So first we will go for functional testing or black box testing. So in the class we'll be seeing, we'll be actually deriving test cases using an example. So we will use SATM system example only in class to derive test cases. So we will see what exactly an SATM system is. Then it will be easy in class. So this is an SATM system. So it communicates with bank with using 15 screens. We have, see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 15 screens we have here. So this is actually the various features in an ATM terminal. Okay, so customers can select any of the transaction types. See here, we have various transaction types here. I hope you can see. So transactions types, they can select, that is deposit, withdrawal and balance inquiries. And it can be done on two types of accounts, that is checking and saving. So when what happens is, when a customer arrives at SATM station, this is the screen that will be displayed. Then when bank customer access the ATM system with the card, with the ATM card, then it will, the customer will be prompted to enter their PIN. Okay, so that will be displayed in screen 2. Now if PIN is correct, that is if the customer information matches with the file, then screen 5 will be displayed, that is select the transaction type. This will be displayed. Now, if the customer's details is not found, then screen 4 will be displayed. Okay. No, oh, I'm sorry. Screen 3 will be displayed and the customer will be given two more chances to enter the PIN. If in two more chances, if the PIN is not correct, then screen 4 will be displayed. Now, in screen 5, on entry of screen 5, the system adds two pieces of information, that is whether it is checking or savings account. Then based on each of the option, this corresponding how the end, let the enter the amount be entered, then all this or see, these are all error messages. Then balance is being updated or temporarily unable to process the deposit. All those corresponding transaction details will be shown in each screen. So these are each screen that will be there. So you should understand what the first condition, when a customer enters, the condition that should exist is welcome. Please insert your ATM card. So that is the first precondition that should exist, so that the input, the card can be inserted. Then screen 2, the details, the personal identification number has to be entered. So that number, when it enters, based on the data input, the next screen should be displayed by the ATM. So this is how it goes. So this is all about SATM system. So please go through it once, and if possible, please write down the various functionalities which this system has, what precondition should exist for each system, what should be the input given, what should be the expected screen or output. All those, if you can write, it will be good, it will be helpful in the coming class. Thank you.